Hi there, I am Giuseppe Corcello from Virtual Orchestration, and today I'm going to review Salu by Orchestral Tools. First of all, I want to thank Orchestral Tools for kindly sending us a copy of the library to review. Salu is a library that stands midway between the acoustic and the textural sound designing world. It offers a combination of acoustic instruments featuring especially fragile and experimental articulations, plus a collection of soundscapes and pad effects. Recorded at the Europart Center near Tallinn, it usually sells for €399 plus VAT, and you can also decide to buy the single instruments separately. It works in Sine Player and the size is 89 GB compressed. I really suggest you to check out the products page as well as the videos on the YouTube channel to find out more about Salu, the idea behind it and how it was sampled. Salu includes 5 categories of instruments: strings, voices, plucked and keys, percussion and processed. As per strings, you have a quartet, solo viola and solo cello. As you can see, they have quite a few articulations, besides some common ones such as sustain, portato, tremolo, pizzicato, spiccato, staccato. You also have some arpeggios and irregular playing styles. There are then 2 vocal ensembles with main and special articulations. Plucked and keys include Cannel, Harp, a Steinway K132 piano and a combination of all of them. Tubular bells, Glockenspiel, Glockenspiel and Crotalis together, vibraphone, chimes, thundersheet, tam-tam, grand cassa, timpani and wind gong, and finally 71 sound design patches divided into icy, evolving, dream state, tense, dark, and plucks. Generally speaking, the instruments included in this library have a quite fragile, intimate, and close sound that recalls Nordic landscapes. You have also quite a few mic positions, including the spot ones, and on some instruments, even more than one spot mic. So you really have a few options to build your own sound. Okay, now let's just play a bit with these instruments and hear how the library sounds.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Hum, 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 hum Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, let's go to the conclusion. The first thing to keep in mind here is that this is a library with a particular vision in mind, and it works better on music that needs a kind of fragile, intimate, close sound. And for the most part, the dynamics are not too loud. And I believe that if you need to compose something like this, Salu can be of great help to you. The samples are very good and very important. They are in general quite dry, so you can really add any other plugin you want with great flexibility. In my review, I made a few examples using a reverb, trying to add a bit of more icy feeling to some instruments, and that worked just fine. The effect was very enjoyable, and the instrument and the sound in general really came to life. I believe that if you add an algorithmic reverb to start with, or some other signal processors, you can create very interesting textures. And this library makes the things easier for you, in my opinion, starting from the almost dry samples, and also thanks to the articulations you can find in there. This can be indeed a quite experimental library if used wisely. There are not just common articulations, but quite a few patches feature arpeggios or improvisations. And if you start to add some processors like a reverb or a delay and play with the mic positions, you can really make all the thing even more interesting. I also believe that this library works particularly well with some of the synth's features, such as the polyphonic articulation mode. If you set some articulations in poly mode to be controlled via CC and crossfade between them, the chances to get something unique increase. And you can also try to increase the dynamic range to get the possibility to play even softer. This is a really great library for soft experimental music, which reminds to icy Nordic landscapes, and it gives you a quite wide sonic palette and instrumentation to work with. It's all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to support Virtual Orchestration, subscribe to the channel, join our newsletter if you wish, hit the like button, and don't forget to click on the bell icon to get notified as soon as we release a new tutorial or a new review. If you are new to the world of the virtual orchestration and you wish to learn more about it, or even if you are a pro or semi-pro looking to improve your skills, we offer private online lessons about virtual orchestration, mockup programming, and how to use Doric, Sibelius, Cubase, and Logic Pro. Get in touch at info@virtualorchestration.it. I wish you a wonderful day and see you on the next review.